Hello YouTube, Jonathan from QTAS here again. I've decided to do a quick blog, and it will be fairly quick, I hope, just to cover a few things I've had through by email. Now, because we specialise in healthy eating, water comes under that heading to a certain extent. I've had quite a lot of questions about that. Questions like, 70% of the planet's covered in water, why do so few people have access to clean water? Why do so many people die? What's better for you, tap or mineral water? Do you need to drink 1 litre of water per day? And what is fresh water? Okay, and there's quite a lot to cover there, and I think that either if I try and cover all of it, we'll be here all night, or you're just going to fall asleep, bored out of your minds. So I'll try and flip through some of it. Yes, the planet is 70% water. However, of that 70%, let's assume that, it's been approximated that most oceans are a couple of thousand foot deep, and so therefore there are 326 billion trillion gallons of water on the planet. However, only 3% of that is fresh water. Now, when we talk about fresh water, according to the Oxford Dictionary, that is just water that has less than 0.5 parts per thousand of dissolved salts. So it's just water that's not salty. So we've got 3% fresh water on the planet. Now, 2/3 of that is frozen. It's in the polar ice caps and it's in glaciers. So that leaves 1% left, which is the available fresh liquid water on the planet. However, it's not necessarily available because only 0.3% of that is actually surface water. The rest of that is held in the soil, it's being filtered through limestone, it's in the water table, it's in the trees, it's in the soil. So that is why there's such a limited amount of water left available. There are desalination plants, there's lots of projects going on to help, but what's better, tap water or mineral water? Well, you could argue that all day. The mineral water's been filtered through limestone. You've still got a lot of the minerals, including calcium, iron, manganese, magnesium, zinc, copper, blah blah blah, etc. in there. Tap water is, on some level, is said to be safer because it's been filtered 15 times before it gets to your tap. However, during that filtering process, a lot of the goodness in the water, the nutrients, the mineral, which your body needs to function, is removed. Is it necessary for you to drink a litre of water a day? Well, that's an argument that's going on at the moment. There are a lot of people that are saying whatever you drink has got a high percentage of water in it. So, to some of them it's no. However, if you're drinking coffee, caffeine of any description, that would be that coffee or tea, then it's also got quite high levels of anti-nutrients in it, which is going to make you excrete a lot more water than if you were just drinking water. So there you go. I hope I've answered those questions. One thing for you to bear in the back of your mind, though, just for you to think over, is that all of this water that is on the planet, although we know that under laboratory conditions we can make water, we know the formula for that, it's fair to say most of the water on the planet hasn't been made. In fact, it's been around for about 4.6 billion years. Now, if all terrestrial organisms on this planet rely largely on fresh water to survive, it's probably fair to say that when you look at a glass of fresh water, that water has been consumed and excreted by any number of different creatures, from T-Rex to your garden slug, over the past 4.6 billion years. So, fresh? I don't know. I'll leave that one with you. Bye.